asked the Lord, I said, Lord, what would you have me say to the people? Say to the peoples. And he gave it to me while I was at work. But he confirmed it when I got home.
All right.
Okay.
All right now.
I'm wondering, oh Lord, you gotta give me a sign, you gotta give me something, because I know I want it from you and not from me.
All right.
Because I know y'all don't want to hear what I have to say, because I don't even want to hear what I gotta say.
Stay in that frame of mind.
Yeah, yes. That's beautiful. Amen. I love that.
But I thank God for giving it to me. So I'm going to start. I'm going to go from, start at Jonah 1, 2, and 3. But I'm going to do the whole chapter. Yes, the first chapter of Jonah. Now the word of the Lord came unto Jonah, the son of Amittai, saying, Arise, go to Nineveh, that great city, and cry against it, for their wickedness is come up before me. But Jonah arose and flee unto Tarshish from the presence of the Lord, and went down to Joppa.
Okay.
And he found a ship going to Tarshish. So he paid the fare thereof and went down into it to go with them unto Tarshish from the presence of the Lord. If I was to leave a thought with you on today, it would be, why run? You can't hide.
Oh.
Go ahead now.
All
right.
You better take your time, Regis. Come on.
Jesus, you can't hide. Jesus,
thank you, Jesus.
Jesus. Jonah, which means dove, was a prophet. A prophet is a teacher or a proclaimer of the word of God. The son of Amittai, Jonah ministered between 800 and 750 B.C. A significant event affected the northern kingdom of Israel in the Old Testament. The word of the Lord came to Jonah and said, Get up, go now at once to Nineveh. Cry means to shout and spare not. Jonah had to preach repentance because their wickedness, their sin, was that of Sodom and Gomorrah.
Come on.
For within, out of the heart of man, evil thoughts perceive wickedness, deceit. Just to give you a few, lasciviousness, pride, greed, bestiality, adultery, just to name a few. A few that defile the man, Mark 7:21-23. They had lost all desire for that which is good in the sight of God. So they was very wicked. And everybody in this city was wicked.
Amen. Come on.
So when you have lost sight of God and what is good, you're in trouble.
Sure. Amen.
So Nineveh had no knowledge and worship of the true God. They didn't worship God. They didn't have no knowledge of him. So they needed some help.
Amen.
So, and Nineveh, wickedness has come up to my attention, has reached to the heavens. So it had came up that far. You know, they say the wages of sin is death.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Their wages was up there.
Uh-oh.
Uh-huh.
Come on now.
The Lord no longer overlooked the wicked things they had done. God was tired.
That's bad.
He was tired, just like he is now.
Come
on.
And Jonah did not want to go because Nineveh was bitter enemies of Israel.
Uh-huh.
Regardless if they was enemies of Israel or not, God told him to go.
That's right.
That's it.
And it says, pray for your enemies. He was such in a bad state that he hated Nineveh because of what they was doing to Israel.
All right now.
But he should have known that when God sent you to do something, you got to go. We all have enemies.
That's it.
Sometimes we don't want to pray for our enemies. Let's be honest.
Yeah.
But we still have to pray for them anyway.
Uh-huh.
And if God says go, me, he means go.
Yeah.
Go talk to them. Go tell them, thus what I said, thus saith the Lord.
Go ahead now.
Amen.
Come on, bring it.
Jonah was like to see the destruction. Jonah had a serious problem. Anytime you want to see destruction on a nation, you have a problem.
That's right.
Amen. Because God is merciful. God is kind. And he has mercy on everybody. He did not want them to repent. Jonah didn't think God should care about them, but God cares about everybody.
Amen.
God does not want to see anybody lost.
Amen.
He wants to get all the souls he can and give them a chance
yes.
to make it to heaven. That wasn't Jonah's call.
Amen.
That was God's call to
speak
call
on
him
it. Speak
to
on
do it.
It. Amen.
God was merciful. He knew that God would withdraw his judgment on them. But Jonah didn't know that. He speculated that God would do that. But first he had to go do what God told him to do instead of thinking in his mind that was going to happen. Jonah wanted to get God to do what Jonah wanted to do. Jonah didn't think about what God wanted Jonah to do.
Right.
Jonah wanted God to do what he wanted to.
Yes.
And it
yes.
doesn't work like that. Well, God is God. And whatever God does, he does.
That's it. Right.
Because he's God.
Yes,
that's
right.
It.
God does what he wants. Jonah disobeyed God. There are serious consequences for disobeying God. So first, after he disobeyed God is a sin.
Absolutely.
So now he's sinning. Because he did not want to go where God told him to go.
Amen.
So Jonah ran away in the opposite direction from the presence of the Lord.
Uh-oh.
He's supposed to be going where God told him to go, but he went to the opposite, doing what he wanted to do.
Mm-hmm.
Like all of us today, we do what we want to do instead of what God wants us to do.
Come on with it.
He got it.
In Psalms 139, where can I go from your presence? He was trying to hide from God's presence. You can't hide from God because God is everywhere.
Yes,
he
is.
His omnipotent presence is everywhere. Yeah. Jonah paid the fare, went down to Tarshish, which and he sinned against God. And you go down, not up. Whatever you sin, you're going down. You're not going up.
Amen.
Because sin takes you down to hell.
Yes.
So he was going down instead of up.
That's right.
So he had already sinned, and God sent a great wind that the ship was likely to be broken because Jonah had sinned and he got in the ship with people that wasn't even bothering him. They was in peace until he got on the ship.
Until he got there.
And sure the enough. Ship started, God sent a great wind, so the ship was almost broken to pieces. And they trying to find out who is this and what is going on. Mm-hmm. Because it wasn't like that before.
Yeah.
So they're trying to figure it out and come to find out Jonah is down sleeping. They begin to cry for your God. And they ask Jonah, why aren't you crying out to God? And Jonah began to tell them what was going on. You know, and they said, well, you can't stay here.
You're
not in danger.
You got to go.
He was getting everybody, people don't understand, but when you sinning against everybody.
And everybody,
is infected by him sinning.
Yep. That's
because
it.
The ship was getting ready to be broken in pieces. They could have lost their lives.
That's yeah. right.
So he's saying, well, throw me overboard.
That's right.
Get out of here.
So they throw him overboard. And thank God sent the whale, a fish, to swallow him up.
That's right.
Because he was disobedient yes. to God. And
man,
they wanted to do what God had to say.
I mean, Missionary Riggins.
Jonah was asleep and uncertain about what was happening.
Yeah.
Jonah did not have, didn't have any guilt, wasn't even thinking about it, just sleeping away.
Mm-hmm.
Like nothing, like God ain't never said anything to him.
Yeah. Oh, he was comfortable.
He got comfortable like God ain't said anything to him. The prepared the fish to swallow Jonah up and in the belly of the fish 3 days and 3 nights. 3 means that God is in control.
Yes.
God is always in control.
Yes.
Yes, he is.
You don't think God is in control, but he's in control.
He sure is.
Jonah was stubborn because Jonah could have changed
mm-hmm.
and did what God had him to do, but he was set on his enemies.
Yep.
Having them destroyed.
Mm-hmm.
So Jonah started praying, asking God for forgiveness and deliverance and thanking God for it. Mm-hmm. Because first, after you sin, you got to ask God to forgive you.
Yeah.
And then after God forgives you, he delivers you.
Yes. Yes.
He delivers you from everything. And then you begin to thank him for it. So Jonah was in the belly of the fish for 3 days, and that's what he was doing. He was asking God for forgiveness and thanking God for his deliverance. And just thanking God for who God is.
Yeah.
Because he had forgot God is in control. You don't tell God what to do.
No, you don't.
So Jonah quoted the word of God from the belly of the fish. The Lord spoke unto the fish and it vomited him out.
That's
it. Amen. Upon the dry land, and God gave Jonah a second chance.
Yes.
I'm so glad he's a second chance God.
Yes. Yes.
He gives
yes.
all of us.
Yes.
He gives all of us a God of many chances.
Yes.
Not
yes.
even really second, is. But a God of many, many. Chances. And
many.
I'm so glad.
Yes.
I'm
yes.
so glad.
Yes.
And Jonah, I know Jonah was glad because Jonah yes. thought he was dying. He had thought that God was going to kill him.
He was.
Yeah, he was, but he gave him a second chance because God has something for Jonah to do.
Yes.
Whenever God has something for you to do, you're going to have a storm in your life. Things might begin to happen to you, but until you repent and ask God to help you, he's going to help you.
Yeah.
But right then, he wants you to do what he wants you to do.
That's right.
Okay. So go down to Nineveh and preach. He said, do what I told you to do the first time. It didn't change. He didn't change his mind about it.
Nope.
He said, now go and do what I told you to do.
Let's go.
Amen. So Jonah went in 3 days' journey, and Jonah cried out. He shouted, yet 40 days and Nineveh shall be overthrown. 40 days is a long time for a righteous God to defer his judgment. That's a long time for God to say, well, okay, they're doing it. I'm going to defer it. But it is God to defer. Yet it is but a little time for unrighteous people to repent and
yes.
reform.
Yes.
But we don't have that much time.
No, nope. We sure don't.
You got to do it now.
That's right.
Repent now.
That's right.
I know that's right.
Then we'll believe the word and that which was spoken by Jonah. They began fasting, moaning, and joining in prayer and supplication to God. See, by Jonah going to tell them, they listened to Jonah.
They did.
Because he knew God.
Yes.
And they knew he knew God because of what he told them. So they began to fast and pray and cry out to God.
That's right.
And repent.
That's right.
So that's what God wanted. He wanted Jonah to do that, to save all his people.
Yes, he did.
But Jonah didn't want to. He wanted to see all of them go to hell.
He wanted destruction.
Yeah, he wanted to see them all be destroyed.
Wow.
But God doesn't want that. He wants to give us a chance.
Yes.
A chance to turn it around.
Yes.
A chance to do God's will.
Yes.
Yes.
Go ahead, Sister Missionary Higgins. You preach the word.
Upon their repentance, God saw this, and that was, he looked for it, and he was quiet. He was looking for that, and he required that, and they did it.
Mm-hmm.
They did what Jonah was preaching to them.
Mm-hmm.
So you have some people that don't want to do anything, though you preach to them.
That's right. That's right.
But they repented.
Mm-hmm.
That's what we have to do. We can't keep doing the same old thing.
No.
We really can.
There comes a time when you got to say, I got to get this together.
For real.
Yeah.
God is calling me to do something. To speak on his behalf to the people because they're dying.
Yes.
And God wants everybody to have a second chance.
He wants everyone to have a chance. Everyone.
Amen. Jonah was angry.
He sure was.
I don't think he was angry at Nineveh, but I think he was angry at God because God
yes,
withdrew.
He was.
God withdrew his judgment from him. And Jonah didn't like it.
He sure did.
He thought he was going to tell God what to do.
Yes, he did.
You can't do that.
No,
you can't.
What?
No, you can't. You can't tell God what to do.
Yes. Good luck with that.
Yeah, they think they can tell God what to do. No, it don't work like that.
God.
Amen.
Whatever pleases God should please us.
That's right.
So Jonah should have been pleased. Because it pleased God, it should have pleased him too.
Amen.
If they were spared. that they didn't get the destruction they should have got.
That's right.
And when Israel ended, when Jonah set to rest, God provided a vine to give him shade. The next day, God sent a worm to eat the vine. Jonah now sat in the hot sun complaining and wanted to die. He still ain't had enough. Complaining about a vine, and he should have been happy that the people repented of their sins and they was not going to get the judgment that God was going to give them.
Man,
he was mad.
Amen.
People do us wrong, but we can't get mad at them. We gotta pray for them.
Pray for them.
Yeah, sometimes you don't want to pray for people.
Don't.
Cause they ain't right.
Y'all trying to tell you.
They ain't right.
Not one.
I done been there.
For real.
I said it in a minute.
So God called out for Jonas. And scolded him for being so concerned about the plant. And God was concerned with the heart condition and the lives of 120,000 people who lived in the city of Nineveh.
Amen.
Jonah was worried about a plant. God was worried about the soul.
Wait a minute.
And that's what Jonah should have been worried about. The souls of the people, not no plant. We worry about a lot of things. The first thing we should be worried about is our soul.
That's right.
Examine ourselves before we lay down at night.
That's right.
So do.
God, am I doing what you have me to do?
That's right.
For real.
God, are you pleased with me?
Amen.
God, if I'm not God, help me to get it right. There's nothing better than doing something on behalf of God.
I know that's right.
Especially when it comes to souls. That's what God is after, souls. He don't want to see nobody lost. But unfortunately, some people are.
It's sad.
But he's looking for a Jonah's in us.
Come on.
He's looking for us. Not to turn our back and run away.
That's right.
But to do what he told us to do.
Amen.
Even though if they're our enemies.
That's Amen. It.
But he told us to pray for them.
That's right.
Try to save them people.
Yeah. So we just have to do what God has us to do.
That's right.
No matter what it takes, no matter what it costs.
Amen. Mm-hmm.
Because we don't know when God is coming back.
Amen.
We don't know, because he can send a storm in our life.
He sure can.
And until we get it together,
we're
going to be in a storm.
Amen.
There's nothing worse than being in a storm and then you ain't going to cry out for God. Something wrong with you.
That's the honest God truth.
Something's wrong with you. You can't cry out for God and you know you need God's help.
Uh-huh. And you know him too.
And you know him.
And you know him. You've been with him.
And you don't want to cry out?
Ain't thinking about it.
God is good.
Yes.
You preach it.
God is good.
Yeah.
Don't pay my stuff in the
world.